Welcome back to my channel, Awesome Learning Children, with the next lesson that we had started. And in the previous video, I told you about what is excretion and various types of nitrogenous wastes that were given out by various types of organisms. So let's again start from here where we had left in the previous video. You can see what is excretion, children. A brief revision. Excretion is the elimination of metabolic waste in the form of ammonia, urea, uric acid, etc. from the body, right? And now, children, we also did this types of excretion. There were three types of excretion: ammonotelism, ureotelism, and uricotelism. We had done this in the previous video. We also told you about ammonotelism, that process of excretion of ammonia. This is the formula of ammonia, NH3, right? Ammonia. Ammonotelic animals like aquatic invertebrates, aquatic insects, bony fishes, aquatic amphibians, they show ammonotelism. And why? NH3, that is ammonia, is highly toxic, so it requires a lot of water. Ammonia is readily soluble in water. This is a feature of ammonia. It is easily soluble in water and is excreted by diffusion through body surfaces or gill surfaces, as in fishes, in the form of ammonium ions, that is NH4 plus ions. So kidney do not play any important or significant role in this room. Then, children, we had ureotelism, that is urea. Ureotelism are seen by cartilaginous fishes, terrestrial and semi-aquatic amphibians like frogs, toads, aquatic and semi-aquatic reptiles like alligators, turtles, mammals. They all show ureotelism. This is the formula of urea, you can see. And ammonia is first converted to urea. And where is this done? It is done in the liver, and less amount of water is required here for this kind of excretion, and some amount of urea is retained. That is, you cannot say that 100% urea is removed, because some amount of urea is retained in kidney's matrix. Why is it retained? What is the reason? The reason is to maintain osmotic pressure. We will do this elaborately when we are doing the concept of excretion, right? Third type was uricotelism. This is the formula of uric acid, you can see, and it was shown by certain insects, land crustaceans, snails, reptiles, and birds. Very little amount of water is required in this type of excretion. So we had done this earlier in the previous video. Now we are going to do with excretory organs in animals, which is a brief paragraph given in your NCERT. Let me just show you this. This is the paragraph in your NCERT, and we have just converted this paragraph into a PPT so that it is easier for you to understand. So let's see here. Excretory organ in some animals. Protonephridia. Now the excretory organ is protonephridia. We also call them as flame cells. Now, where are these type of excretory organs seen? You see, platyhelminthes. Yes, we call them as platyhelminthes, rotifiers, and some annelids, and cephalochordates. These are the animals which have protonephridia as their excretory organs. Next, annelids have nephridia as their main excretory organ. Insects have malpighian tubules as their excretory organ. Crustaceans like prawns have adrenal glands or green glands as their excretory organs, and higher animals, even us, we the mammals, have kidneys as their excretory organs. So these are the various type of organisms and their excretory organs in a tabulated form. Okay, so children, very little has been given here. Let me show you your NCERT also. Let's see here. A survey of animal kingdom present a variety of excretory structures. Most of the invertebrates, these structures are simpler tubular forms, simple tube-like structures, whereas in vertebrates, it is quite complex, like our kidneys. So, some of these structures are protonephridia or flame cells in platyhelminthes. Who are the platyhelminthes? The flatworms like planaria, rotifiers, some annelids and cephalochordates. And they have given you the example of cephalochordates also, amphioxus, right? Protonephridia are primarily concerned with ionic and fluid volume regulation, that is osmoregulation. Now, this is the line which you should write down in your notes, very important. Let me tell you what do they mean and what they want to say. Children, always remember that our organs inside the body, they are actually you can say filled up with lot of fluids inside and outside. Like there is a fluid called blood, there is a fluid called lymph, there is water present inside our body. So 95 to 97% of our body is filled up with fluid, and these fluids have to maintain their concentration. Osmoregulation means the concentration. Now just imagine that there is an organ. And the organ is filled up with a fluid and it is getting filled up again and again. What will happen? A time will reach, or you will come to a time when the organ is overfilled. And due to that overfilling, it can burst out. Right? So to balance it, kya hota hai? Outside that organ there is fluid, and inside also the organ is filled up with fluid. Now to balance it, what happens? Movement will take place from high concentration to low concentration, so that the osmotic pressure outside and inside is maintained. So body automatically does this. Now, अब वी इनसाइड आर बॉडी, मैं आपको एक एग्जाम्पल बताती हूँ. हमारे बॉडी में बहुत सारे ऐसे ऑर्गन्स हैं एंड वी डू नॉट नो दैट हमारी बॉडी के कौन से ऑर्गन का कौन सी ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर जो है वो बैलेंस्ड नहीं है, क्योंकि बॉडी ऑटोमेटिकली उसको बैलेंस कर लेती है. लेकिन ये बैलेंसिंग कैसे होता है? इट इज डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ आर एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन्स. आपने चेक किया होगा कि बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि इन समर्स हमारे को यूरिन जो है वो बहुत कम आता है, या आता है तो वॉल्यूम कम होता है, लेकिन विंटर्स में बार बार आता है और वॉल्यूम ज्यादा होता है. क्यों होता है ऐसा? टू मेंटेन एन ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. कौन कर रहा है ये मेंटेनेंस? हमारा एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम. रिमेंबर दिस चिल्ड्रेन, हर ऑर्गेनिज्म में अगर आप ये लिख देते हो कि एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम हेल्प्स इन द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ और रेगुलेशन ऑफ आयनिक एंड फ्लूइड वॉल्यूम, आपको मार्क्स मिल जाएंगे. अब रिमेंबर दिस, प्रोटोनेफ्रीडिया इज एन एक्सक्रीटरी पार्ट और ऑर्गन इन these organisms like flatworms or like cephalochordate. तो इनकी body में kidneys नहीं है इनका excretory organ. इनकी body में इनका excretory organ कौन है बेटा? Protonephridia. तो उसका काम क्या है? Waste को of course throw करना तो एक काम है ही है, because नाम ही excretory organ है, waste तो वो throw करेगा. लेकिन along with throwing out the waste, दो काम और करता है वो. क्या? आयनिक बैलेंस, आयंस को बैलेंस करना, एंड फ्लूइड वॉल्यूम को भी बैलेंस करना या रेगुलेट करना. तो इन दोनों को कलेक्टिवली हम क्या बोलते हैं? ऑस्मोरेगुलेशन. रिमेंबर दिस, ऑस्मोरेगुलेशन मीन्स टू रेगुलेट द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. रिमेंबर दिस, बॉडी का एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन कोई भी हो उसका ये काम है, एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन का, एक तो टू थ्रो आउट द वेस्ट, दूसरा टू रेगुलेट द आयनिक बैलेंस, तीसरा टू रेगुलेट द फ्लूइड वॉल्यूम इनसाइड द बॉडी. सो फॉर एवरी एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन इफ यू राइट दीज लाइन्स यू विल गेट मार्क्स. चिल्ड्रन नेक्स्ट इज नेफ्रीडिया, ट्यूबुलर एक्सक्रीटरी स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ अर्थवर्म्स एंड अदर एनालिड्स. नेफ्रीडिया अगेन हेल्प टू रिमूव नाइट्रोजिनस वेस्ट. सी आई टोल्ड यू एवरी एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन विल हेल्प टू रिमूव व्हाट, वेस्ट, एंड मेंटेन अ फ्लूइड एंड आयनिक बैलेंस. सेम थिंग. नेक्स्ट मालपीजियन ट्यूब्यूल्स आर एक्सक्रीटरी स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ मोस्ट ऑफ द इंसेक्ट्स इंक्लूडिंग कॉकरोचेस. व्हाट विल दे डू? सी मालपीजियन ट्यूब्यूल्स हेल्प इन टू द रिमूवल ऑफ नाइट्रोजिनस वेस्ट एंड osmoregulation. So every excretory organ have the same work. What is the work? They will throw out the waste, they will balance the ions, they will balance the fluid inside the body. Adrenal glands, also called green glands, perform excretory function in crustaceans like prawns. So this was the table which has been shown to you. You can add one more column here and you can write down the functions of all the organisms or the excretory organs, because functions are same in everyone. Functions are same. What are the functions? To throw out the excretory waste, to balance the ions, and to balance the fluid volume of the body. That means to show osmoregulation. Right? So this was about various types of excretory organs. In the next video, we will be starting with the human excretory system.